the sun is setting and you're right here by my side. And the movie is playing, but we won't be watching tonight.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
It begins with an L. Like the L word.
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
Oh, heads up.
Yeah, honey, nice catch.
Thank you. Man, the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god. Okay, just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it. What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, how'll it happen to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
No bars.
Of course not.
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it? Hey, eyes on the road!
Whoa!
Max! Stop the car!
Peace.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, Max, it wasn't a bear.
What was it?
I think it was a person.
Lou, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't... What is it?
I really effed this car up.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is.
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
Thanks, huh?
Yeah. Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
Here you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
And then picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
Well, anywhere's better than here.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Just stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
What? You're not the boss of me.
I just don't want you wandering off on your own.
Excuse me.
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, it better not be.
I'm sorry. I really gotta concentrate for a second, okay?
Yes. Look, I think there's someone down there, okay?
What's that?
They could be hurt. I'm gonna go check it out. Good idea, Laura. So thoughtful of you. Rose.
Hey, hey, why are you shouting? What?
No, but I heard something. Let's just get out of here.
Come on!
Oh, God, I thought you said you checked it.
I did check it, and it was fine. Honey, I know you're on edge, but you gotta calm down, okay?
I am not on edge, Max. I'm freaking the fuck out.
It was probably just an animal or something.
No, it wasn't an animal. You didn't see it. It was a woman.
Lord, this isn't helping, all right? Go! There we go. We're good. See?
Please just get us out of here.
Okay. I'm trying. We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jeez!
Oh, fuck! Oh my God, my heart just exploded.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
You folks want to tell me what happened here?
Yeah. Well, we were just driving, and it's really, really dark out here, and, I don't know, we must have hit like a pothole or something, because we swerved and now here we are. I mean, these roads are really not in great shape.
Yeah.
Sir?
Keep the car running.
Sir?
Is this guy like the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know, this is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Now, you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out, you know? I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem...
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Ma'am, if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle, I would just like to show you a route on your map there.
Okay. For sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
It's okay.
Okay.
Okay. So, we... are right about here. Harbinger Motel is here.
Right, okay, and where was Hackett's quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning. Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road. Watch out for potholes.
Oh, you need like
a
statement?
Have a good night.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
That guy was giving me major weirdo
vibes. The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
Hackett's quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's... debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car, and this is a complete waste
Why
of time.
Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll beat the car.
Max, come on. Max, don't be a dick.
I'm sorry.
What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
okay? I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help. Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Let me see.
There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so... You sure?
Yeah, saw it online.
Damn. You need a hand?
Yeah.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
Hello? Are you hurt?
Do you exist?
Hey, be careful.
Max?
Hun, maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey, it's been kind of a night. You know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Max? Max! Max!
Miss what? I think I'm bleeding a lot.
No! No! No!
look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please.
My friend, welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you. I've waited, yes. So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes. And terrifying. But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other. You didn't find anything, and so I've nothing to show you. You need to look harder. The cards are out there. If you don't help me, how can I help you? We're supposed to be friends. You said so yourself. Search harder. Only you can find them. There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover on which I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
I mean, you never know. The universe has a kind of way of working these things out.
The universe?
Yeah, like the cosmic space gods.
Space gods.
You heard me?
Okay, spell it.
It's nothing to spell. You know, we're cool.
Oh, so cool.
We are super cool.
So she dumped her ass, huh?
Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before, right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Beat a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will ya?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Hey, what are you listening to?
Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke.
Good to know. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's
I gotta get the last bags in there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan, please.
Sorry, bro.
Cool. Thanks, guys. Skill. Okay, really, dude? Locking me out?
Okay, in my defense, A, it was Dylan's idea, and two, it was really funny.
Oh, yeah, right. Is that right?
I don't write the rules, man.
Okay, whatever. Look, are you gonna help me with the bags or what?
Nah, I gotta stay here and wait for Mr. H to return our cell phones. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Okay, and why are the stairs blocked?
Well, apparently it's to keep raccoons and other pesky varmints from ransacking the place. Mr. H's words, not mine.
Oh! Boring! All right, got the bags.
Great, all by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my God, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Oh, okay, so now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake. Oh, sorry, I just got so distracted about that rhyme. I forgot what we were...
Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Ah, sexy, huh?
Hottest at camp, by far.
Okay, sure.
Look, it was all settled by the girls in bunk 7, like, second day of camp. It goes Ryan, me, of course, then Dylan, Emma, Abby.
Okay.
Nick, and then Mr. H, and...
Okay, are you almost finished? Please?
Yep, that's it. That's everyone. So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we gonna make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know, maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob.
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she just got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
No, but I mean, seriously, come on, she's right. It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was going to happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house, kid, affair, kid, divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation lawsuit, surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement, grandkid, nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind in the ballpark? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all-men list.
Well, that seems legit. Okay, so are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet. And you're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up. Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out. Oh, this looks important. Shit. I will hook you right back up tomorrow, okay? Pinky promise.
Up here, my dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please.
Don't.
Oh, Nick! Boom. Oh, there it is.
Oh, man, good save.
Freak.
Oh.
Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. Surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is... being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Okay, well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burned.
Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get this show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick,
You're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah. Keep dreaming, Junior.
Hey there, party bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Oh boy, you're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Door's locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. Then by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get in trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
Why would this place be in the news? Aw, this was little Izzy's.
I want to play a game.
Yeah, you can probably just stay here, you creepy little thing. I can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs. Ouch. Let's hope Jacob hasn't seen this. Ugh. Ew, what is that? Is it Dylan's? Ugh.
Thank you.
Ready to roll?
Let's do it. Finally.
Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there. Eyes on the road, lady.
Sorry. Okay, so hypothetically, if I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school, like, 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. Why don't you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up! Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp.
Yes. Sure. What's the victory?
2 months. No technology.
I kind of thought it was nice to be offline.
Ugh, I didn't. Plus, my subs need me.
You know what? I actually believe you.
Abby, was that a compliment?
Your charm is infectious. What can I say? I'd subscribe.
You better. As soon as you get home, sub, share, smash that like button. The Holy Trinity.
Okay, well now I'm really regretting it.
Oh no, you love me. My favorite spot?
The fire pit?
The island. Mad secluded, right? Is that smoke?
Should we tell someone?
It looks pretty contained. It's probably just Mr. H burning some stuff before, you know, he closes camp for the summer.
Yeah. Speaking of which, we should probably, you know, get back.
Oh yeah, worried Nick's, you know, gonna leave without you.
Well, no, they're probably like all waiting for us.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Everyone, yeah. Nick, waiting for you. All, everyone, same.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is, like, patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No!
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Ignore her, please.
Let's go. Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here, let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Cool.
Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you. Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
You think I was listening to a podcast about you?
Okay, if anyone here had a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
At least I don't look and smell like a butt.
No, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, weirdly enough. The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now? What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
If I did, would I be asking dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you. Or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time he told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
We had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up. Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to press the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Ugh!
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
Good man.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds.